Brian Hamrick reporting live for us. Now a story you'll see only here on WLWT. Allegations of abuse at a local jail, and tonight we have the video.
And WLWT is leading the way tonight investigating these allegations. Curtis Fuller went digging for answers for us today.
This video, obtained by WLWT, is at the heart of a lawsuit filed in Grant County against the detention center.
It's disgusting to see that somebody would be treated in that manner.
She was intoxicated. She was highly belligerent, yelling, cursing, screaming. She had attempted to escape on two or three occasions. So we had our hands full that evening.
The video shows 48-year-old Lonzi Maggard Owen at the detention center the night of July 14th. She was arrested after her husband said she fired a gun at him. She was charged with wanton endangerment and discharging a firearm.
At that point, she's brought to our detention center, and we have to perceive her as a dangerous person.
We're not talking about, you know, normal punishment if someone's committed a crime. We're not talking about that sort. So we're talking about this sort of extra unjustified torture.
Tough words, but that's what's being claimed in this lawsuit filed by the woman and her husband. Take a look. At one point, she is slumped over on a bench and then falls to the ground. Deputies came over and eventually put her in a wheelchair and then restrained her. One of the deputies sprayed pepper spray in her face.
You should have a reasonable expectation that your civil rights, that your person is not going to be harmed.
She's looking around and she's waiting on a deputy to walk by. Now, as soon as my deputy turns the corner, she throws herself on the ground and starts yelling about her neck and her head being injured.
Now, the jailer says overall he supports his staff and will fight any lawsuit. He's conducting an internal investigation and has also turned this case over to the Kentucky State Police. In the meantime, he has reassigned the deputy who used pepper spray in that video. In fact, that deputy has actually been reassigned now and will have to retrain on certain areas in the policy. So he was concerned enough about it to reassign that individual, but he says he still supports them.
Right, but not in the clear just yet. They're going to continue investigating.
Absolutely.
All right, Curtis Fuller, live for us tonight.